issues, and like I said earlier, you know, this is 90s, you know, inspiration. This is, these were the shoes that, you know, was worn in 1990s. And Britney Spears was our brand ambassador at that point of time. Yeah, I mean, she actually was, you know, endorsing this product line.
She was iconic.
Yeah, she was iconic. Yeah. And that trend is coming back. So, you know, the whole chunky sneakers, dad sneakers, ugly sneakers, the way they call it.
But the cool thing about Skechers is, and I've noticed this because I've always been a huge fan of it, they've been making chunky sneakers for the longest time.
Absolutely.
Even though it's back in style from the 90s, I feel that you guys have been making it since early 2000s.
Yeah.
So, yeah, right? So it's like it's always been there.
It's been with us all the time. So
you guys are way before your time.
Yes.
For the time, yeah.
Yeah, we've just gone from chunky to chunkier.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Yes.
Absolutely. Yeah. But Jacqueline, of course, you wear Skechers every day. You're an ardent lover of them. And of course, as far as the youth of our nation is concerned, you're iconic, right? Oh. So what do you have to say about D-Lites? What was your first thought when you saw them?
I love them. I love them. They sent me, Skechers sent me, I think you guys sent me four options. All the colors are so cool because like they go with almost every outfit. Like every single outfit I was wearing, and with this outfit especially, all of my Skechers D-Lites were going with it. So it was just about mixing and matching. It's easy to pair up with anything. It's easy to pair up with casuals. It's easy to pair up with formals. What I love most about the chunkiness of it is that it gives you a little bit of height on the heel.
It does.
Yeah, so, which I love.
Almost 2 inches.
Almost 2 inches, right?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Which I, of course,
always
need.
Yeah, exactly. Me too.
I can always do with two more inches.
I will always opt for height, for sure, any day.
Fantastic. Okay, so for everyone who's watching us right now, tell us, what's your personal sense of style?
My personal sense of style would probably be something, and it's always been this way, it's been comfortable. So comfort is of utmost importance to me. And I think also something that personifies, I think, fitness, mm-hmm. you know, so something that's like kind of fit and fun and yeah, but I think it's mainly been comfort. It's not so much about the trends, but like what you're comfortable actually wearing.
Which is great, which is how it should be. Rahul, my next question's to you. Of course, with the success and expansion, where do you see Skechers in the Indian market 5 to 10 years from now?
Well, that's too long for me to think. but yeah, India has been a great market for us. You know, in the last 5 years, we have kind of moved up pretty fast. And I think Indians love the shoes that we bring in. They're very comfortable. As of today, we are like 250 stores. We just completed our Jan to December calendar, and the numbers are pretty awesome.
So wait, when I launched your 200 store,
yes.
which was in October,
we are at 230 stores right now.
Guys, that's 30 stores, in like less than three months. Like,
yeah, I was telling you, we open, you know, a store every 3 days. So that's the speed at which we are expanding. Yeah, so
I guess we really love our Skechers here.
We do. Why not? Okay, so Jacqueline, there's no doubt that every time we see you, we think, oh, wow, she looks perfect today. But to you, what's your perfect look? Like, on what day, when you're wearing what kind of clothes would you say, oh, my God, I'm looking perfect. This is it.
Wow, that's crazy. I mean, I don't think, I know it's something that people should be doing. It's like, it's a confidence thing, but oh my God, looking in the mirror and saying, hey, I look perfect. But I don't think that's something I think I concentrate on. Mm-hmm. I think like more so like, if I'm looking in the mirror, I would think to myself, am I being me? Am I being true to me? Because a lot of the times, I mean, like, this is especially before in the past where, you know, you get dolled up for your red carpets or you get dolled up for pictures or whatever it is, but you're not being yourself.
Right.
So I think the days that I really feel good about myself is the day I'm being the truest to myself. And that would be, you know, again, like I said, I'm at my most comfortable. Right. I'm at my most ease. And I'm just being who I am. I'm being free.
And that was the answer I was looking for.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Fantastic. So, you know, I mean, the first time I saw these shoes, of course, I was immediately transported to the 90s and, you know, back to that phase where I was just out of school and back to college. Jacqueline, what's your...
Yeah. You're so
classic.
90s today.
I am. I'm like this every day, actually.
Like,
so these are made for people like
me.
Yeah,
the hoops. We're both wearing hoops.
Yeah, totally.
We're going,
So, okay, finally, Jacqueline, before I throw the floor open to questions, yes. What's your, of course, you gave me a pretty good answer to the previous question, but what's your, you know, what's ultimately, what do you want to tell the youth of our nation?
Oh, wow. So, I guess I want to just reiterate the fact that it is important to be yourself, but I am actually seeing that in today's youth because we have so much exposure to what our youth is doing nowadays right. through so many various social media platforms. And I have to say that I don't think I've seen such an amazing generation of young entrepreneurs, young thinkers, people who are very, very like switched on and very aware. So I want to say just, you know, be that person, continue being that person who speaks up, who has a voice, you have a voice now. I feel like the youth have this amazing thing, which was there, it was there in our time too, but like they also, this technology that they have now, use it and use it for the betterment, use it to achieve your goals, use it to rise above, and use it in a good way, in a good positive way.
Fantastic. On that note, I've been told that we have only enough time to take two questions, okay? So in case you have a question directed to Jacqueline, of course, I don't need to tell you, but let's keep the question very brief and very specific to the reason why we're here. So if you have a question for the occasion, please raise your hand. I think we answered all the questions, you know.
Oh, you guys are having
fun.
No, they're saving it for their, I know, their TikToks.
Okay, fantastic. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to quickly move into the photo opportunity. Okay, we have one question.
Huh. Yes. Number one is they should not wear inappropriate clothes according to the weather because... Yeah, I've noticed a lot of people do that. Also, they should, I think, dress according to what suits them. That usually is something, I mean, but you know, we have enough, like, common sense to know that, but I think it's important. Some people tend to, I think, like, avoid that, but it is important.
Is there something that you would never wear?
Never say never, no. something I would never wear? I don't know, actually. I'm an actor. I mean, like, for me, it's like we have to switch into different roles, so I would never say never in that regard, no.
Okay, fantastic. That's all the time we have. Jacqueline, we're going to quickly move into the photo opportunity right here. So I'm going to take your mic.